Picture this. You're watching a junior developer push code straight into production on their first day. Your heart stops a little. Now imagine that junior is an AI, and it's happening right now across your entire organization without you even knowing it. Welcome to Kilo Agentic Engineering. I'm going to show you how to turn that chaos into your competitive advantage. Because here's the thing, 90% of tech workers are already using AI at work, but only 13% of companies have any plan in place for that. This gap represents a significant opportunity. This isn't just another AI is going to replace developers in 6 months course, but it's also definitely not an AI is just hype either course. It's about the messy middle ground where real work happens. You're going to learn how to manage AI, program with it, collaborate with it, just like you'd manage that eager, brilliant, occasionally terrifying junior developer who types faster than they think. Over the next few modules, we're going to transform how you work with AI, not as a deterministic tool, but as a teammate. And I'm going to show you exactly how teams at hundreds of other companies are already doing it successfully. Right now, your team is probably in what I call the BYO AI era. Bring your own AI. Developers are copying proprietary code into personal ChatGPT accounts. They're expensing random AI subscriptions. They're generating mountains of code that look perfect until you know you actually run it. And if you're a senior engineer watching all of this, you've probably become a human linter, spending more time reviewing AI slop than actually building. And that's not sustainable. And that's not why you got into engineering. Here's what we're gonna do differently. We're not gonna assume that AI is a deterministic tool that produces perfect outputs. We're instead gonna embrace the reality that AI is actually non-deterministic and use that to our advantage. We're gonna treat the generative AI tools like they really are and how they act today. And that's like an energetic, enthusiastic, very emboldened junior developer. One who's, you know, read every programming book ever written, but has never shipped production code. One who works at the speed of electricity, but won't admit when they're out of their depth. Think of it this way. AI isn't just another hammer that you put in your bag and you swing. It's an apprentice carpenter that you can collaborate with. And like any apprentice, it needs very clear blueprints and proper supervision. Once you understand that mental model, everything else can click. The weird outputs make sense, the confident hallucinations become more predictable, and most importantly, you know exactly how to manage it and get the most from it. In this course, we're going to master 6 critical skills. First, working professionally with AI agents in enterprise environments. Not just a toy for building demos, but a tool we can use with real production systems with real constraints on them. Second, we're going to apply verification and quality assurance to AI-generated code because we know that it's compiled isn't the same as it's correct. Third, we're going to talk about navigating the minefield of business needs like security, compliance, intellectual property, the stuff that keeps your compliance and legal teams up at night. Fourth, we're going to talk about how you can lead teams through AI adoption without all the chaos and create systems that scale beyond an individual experiment with AI. Fifth, we're going to talk about orchestrating complex, multi-developer projects where AI agents can actually work alongside humans seamlessly. And sixth, we're going to talk about maintaining professional responsibility for every line of code, whether we started writing it or the AI started writing it. This course is for professional developers who want to stay relevant, for team leads who need to scale their impact, for engineering managers trying to harness AI without losing control. Step one in this journey is going to be disregard the AI fast code generating slop demos that are very popular as a new AI tool or AI model becomes released. Instead, we're going to use what I call modes of thinking approach. Because software engineering isn't just one activity, it's also planning and implementing and debugging and learning. And you need different strategies for each of these modes. We'll work with real code bases, not just toy examples. We'll deal with legacy systems, technical debt, and you know the beautiful mess that is production software. By the end of this course, you won't just be using AI, you'll be orchestrating it. You'll know when to trust it, when to constrain it, and when to take the wheel yourself. Here's how to keep the most out of this course. Keep a log of what works and what doesn't. Pause and try things with your own code base. Your notes from this course can then become your team's playbook for implementing the ideas here. The developers that are getting the most out of AI today aren't the ones that are accepting every suggestion. They're not the vibe coders. They're ones who understand that it's not about replacing their work. It's about leverage. And that's exactly what you're about to learn. Let's get started.